I'm not gonna be allowed to film, am I?
I literally had to tempt pass with food so that I could film this video. So if things go wrong again, like they have in my last few videos, I'm done. Hey everyone, it's Ellie from Earl Grey Books. Today we are doing my February-March book haul. I've been putting this off for ages and ages because I just didn't feel like filming a book haul. And then I was like, I'll just put February and March together. And then, yes. So it's not a huge haul, but it is significantly bigger than ones that I have been doing recently. Reason for that is I've got a few books here that I got given slash sent. I also finally caved and bought something from work. We're just gonna start because I am rambling. So I went out for lunch with my friend Angel. We do this like semi-regularly where we go to this dumpling place, or one of two dumpling places that we really like, and eat literally $100 worth of dumplings. But it's fine because we share, because we like all the same things, and we have like a system now. Like, we're pretty good at it. Anyway, we were walking back to Starbucks, and we went past, I think these are Australian wide. It's those bookstores that are like, all books are $10. I think it's called the Book Grocer. Anyway, we went in there. Angel went a little crazy. I was reasonably good. And I picked up two books. And yes, so the first one I have is The Social Sex, A History of Female Friendship by Marilyn Yellum and Theresa Donovan Brown. I bought this one because I've been in a huge nonfiction kick lately, but also because it was February and I started reading it then and I thought that I would finish it. I got 32 pages into it and I was really enjoying it. February got mad and there were so many books that I started, as you were about to see, that I just didn't have time to finish. And yeah, this was one of them. But I do want to continue this. I'm in a little bit of a, like, classics fiction mode at the moment. But hopefully I will finish this one in April. And the other one I bought that day was Schindler's Ark by Thomas Kennelly, and I'm sure most of you know what this is about. I've never read this, I've never seen the movie either, because I always wanted to read the book first. And yeah, I've never found the book, it's always been really expensive. It's one of those weird ones that, like, this size for a paperback is like $22.99 instead of just $20, and I can't spend another $3 on books, guys. Anyway, yeah, I just wanted a reasonably cheap copy. This was $6, I think, something like that, or even $5. Anyway, it was cheap, and I got it, and I started reading it the very start of this month. I took this home with me. So after I went into hospital, I went back to my dad's house for a few days because when I'm not feeling well, I just like to stay with my dad and my dad and my brother, so that there's someone to like keep an eye on me, basically. Anyway, I started reading it, then I literally read the first like chapter, but I started doing something that I haven't done since high school, and I started like annotating, and honestly I don't think I'm gonna continue it because it was kind of, for me it was kind of like pulling away from the enjoyment of this book, and I don't think that that's gonna be like annotations in general for me, but with this book it's just, I was picking up on a lot of things that I didn't like. There's a lot of sexism in the first prologue bit, and I do kind of also like that will still annoy me whether I'm annotating or not, but I also really want to pay attention to like the actual like Jewish stories that are hopefully going to be in this. So yeah, I'm not sure I'm going to keep annotating, and also it took me like 30 minutes to read the first 33 pages, which is not all of those are like word pages too. So yeah. Okay, now I've got some poetry. There's a little poetry bookshop in Melbourne, and I went in there and I picked up these two. This is Confessional Box by Vanessa Page, and this is Honey and Hemlock by Julie Watts. They were both $5. I think they're secondhand ones. They're a little bit beat up. But yeah, that's pretty cheap for poetry, and that's really all I have to say about them. Okay, now I've got four books that I've bought from work. Okay, three books that I've bought from work, and one that also has to do with work. Firstly, I got a copy of Far From the Tree by Robin Benway. This is an ARC, and I got this one to read, and then I will send back to HQ. I've talked about that one in a video recently, so I'm not going to go into it. Another poetry one, this is Night Sky with Exit Runes by Ocean Byong, I think. I believe this won the T.S. Eliot Prize this year, very, very recently. And yeah, I saw it and it was on sale, and I thought that I would just get it. So I did. I'm gonna have quite a stack here. One that I'm super excited for and have already started reading. This is City of Saints and Madmen by Jeff Vandermeer. I feel like, this is gonna be a huge statement, guys, Jeff Vandermeer might possibly be one of my new favorite authors. I've only read Annihilation by him so far, but I love that book so much that I feel like that's a possibility. So like last year was like my year of Atwood, where I read like so much Atwood. I feel like this year may be my year of Vandermeer. I love how that rhymes. That's so cool. Okay. Yeah, started reading this one also in February. So I got 46 pages into it, and I loved the first chapter. It was incredible. And yeah, I just can't wait to get through this one, even though it's huge, and then just get my hands on all of the Vandermeer, and then just Vandermeer it up. I don't know. And then the final one I got this one just the other day. This is The Blood Miracles by Lisa McErney. I'm currently reading The Glorious Heresies, and I have it from the library, and I really, really liked it. And yes, I saw this one was on sale, and I was like, you need to come home with me. Because, yes. Anyway, I haven't read the back or anything because it is I believe it's a sequel or at least a companion to Glorious Heresies, so I don't want to spoil myself. But yes, I am super, super excited for this one. And maybe, hopefully, if I finish the Glorious Heresies in March, I'm not going to finish it. I will hopefully read that one in April and, you know, continue the Irish Readathon into April, because yes, we're on to the last couple now. First one I got sent and it arrived today just in time for me to film this. This is The Things We Can't Undo by Gabrielle Reed. So I got sent this by Gabrielle in the exchange for an honest review, and I'm part of the blog tour that's going on soon. So yes, I will be reading this very shortly and participating in that, and I will let you know how that goes. And then finally, four books left. We'll do these three together. I got myself some of the new Penguin Modern little books here. So I've got Television Was a Baby Crawling Toward That Death Chamber by Allen Ginsberg. The Breakthrough by Daphne du Maurier, which I started reading on the train, and I'm 28 pages into it. And then I also got Dark Days by James Baldwin. I picked these three for very specific reasons, not realising that I'd picked books 2, 3 and 38. These are the ones that like most interest me. I got Daphne du Maurier because obviously she's one of my favourite authors. I really like Howl by Allen Ginsberg, so I wanted to read something else by him. And I really want to read James Baldwin. There are two books of his that specifically stand out. So Giovanni's Room, which I think is probably his most popular, and then Go Tell It on the Mountain. And I thought that this would be a good like entryway into his work. So I'm gonna give that one a go. And then yeah, I will probably pick up some more of these because I do really like them. And then finally, this is completely different to any book I've ever showed on this channel. I got myself a cookbook. This is Cravings by Chrissy Teigen. There's a hair. Basically, from this new hospital trip, I did the whole like, I need to look after myself better. What's the best way to look after yourself better as a diabetic? Eat better food. So this isn't like a diabetes cookbook, because I hate those, because the stuff, like the ingredients that they tell you to like substitute stuff, they're just like so obscure, and I can just do extra insulin if I have to. I mean, like I'm using this for like dinner meals. There's not a whole lot of sugar in this stuff. So yes, I bought this one because I'd seen a YouTube video of her cooking, I think it was like coconut chicken or something, and it looked really good. So I thought I would like just have a look at it, in the store, and there was just like so much stuff in there that sounded amazing that, I had to get it. So like, I originally opened it up to this page. And there's like a whole section here, like a couple of different pages of just potatoes, and I love potatoes. So yeah, I really like the sound of a couple of these. I can't wait to like actually try some of this stuff, and also it's just so gorgeous one, and I think Chrissy Teigen is hilarious. So yeah, pretty excited for this one. And there we go. Those are all of the books that I bought in February and March. I will see you all on Friday. I have a very exciting video that I filmed way back at the start of February with my friend Sarah. That's just been like waiting to be like uploaded and shown to the world. So I hope you'll all enjoyed that one, and yeah. Thanks for watching. Bye.